I suggest you tell your crew I didn't risk their lives unnecessarily.
Yeah,
huh? We'll make things easier going forward.
Edie, tell the crew to assemble. We've got a lot to talk about.
Of course, Shepard.
Well, if I'm going to tell them that. Not getting a chance to ask him all the things I wanted to. Those eyes, man. He's like he's got cyborg eyes.
So the elusive man didn't sell us out. Could have fooled me.
Lied to us. Used us. Needed access to the collector databanks. Necessary risk.
Yeah, I still don't like it.
He tries something like that again, and the collectors will be the least of his problems.
Mm-hmm.
Edie, are you sure this IFF is gonna work?
My analysis is accurate, Shepard. I have also determined the approximate location of the collector homeworld, based on navigational data from their vessel. That can't be right.
What? Where is it? Check Edie's systems?
Better run the diagnostics, Joker. Looks like our AI's got a bug in the software.
My calculations are correct. The Collector homeworld is located within the galactic core.
Can't be. The core is just black holes and exploding suns. There are no habitable planets there.
Could be an artificial construction. Space station protected by powerful mass effect fields and radiation shields.
Even the collectors don't have that kind of technology.
Hmm. Sovereign did.
The collectors are just servants of our real enemy. We've all seen what their masters are capable of. They built the mass relays and the Citadel. Who's to say they can't build a space station surrounded by black holes? No wonder nobody's ever returned from a trip through the Omega-4 mass relay.
The logical conclusion is that a small safe zone exists on the far side of the relay. A region where ships can survive. Standard relay transit protocols would not allow safe transport. Drift of several thousand kilometers is common, and would be fatal in the galactic core. The Reaper IFF must trigger the relay to use more advanced encrypted protocols.
Huh. This might have been what Arkiev 1976 was talking about. We need to build our team.
Just because we can follow the collectors through the relay doesn't mean we can take them out. I don't want to go after them until I know we're ready.
Sooner or later, we need that IFF. I say, why wait?
It's a derelict Reaper.
It's in the game.
What if the collectors are waiting for us? We may want to build up our team before we take that kind of risk.
Stick with building a team.
The more people we have on our side, the better our chances of success. We need to keep building up the team.
It's your call, Commander. Whatever you decide, we're with you.
Hmm. Acquire Reaper IFF. Go to the... Okay, we got plus 11 Renegade, plus 7 Paragon. Research for damage protection and tech damage. And that's it. Another journal. Stop the collectors. The collector ship yielded two key pieces of information. First, the collectors are actually the ancient Protheans, indoctrinated and mutated into the servants of the Reapers. Second, the Omega-4 relay leads to the galactic core. The intense gravitational fields of the galactic core make any jump through the Omega-4 relay a death sentence unless a Reaper Identify Friend or Foe IFF device can be found to give the Normandy a chance to navigate the fields safely. Go to the brown dwarf Nemzine in the Thorn system to recover the Reaper IFF. Yeah, not doing that soon. We're gonna finish whatever else we've got before that. Samara has another personal matter she wants to discuss. Guess that won't stop flashing until I choose something. Not choosing something.
What's this area of the ship?
This is the FTL communi- in addition This allows lag-free communication even when you operate off the comm grid. Logging you out, Shepard.
Alright, so... yeah, gonna be crew update 7.
What's this area of the ship?
Oh, I don't want that.
This is the armory, where small arms are maintained and upgraded. Using Omnitool, computer-aided design, and manufacturing, we have the capability to manufacture several new models.
Arc projector? Collector particle beam. I don't use it that often, so... gonna conserve it and just use it for real powerful baddies that I can't defeat otherwise. Like the what do you call it? Whatever that huge thing was that I fought. The Praetorian.
I hope we can clear up what's going on with the Gernsback, Commander. Doubt my father's alive after all this time. Was there anything else? Just eager to get going.
I'm more interested in just talking for a bit.
Already? I'm not big on forcing these talks, Shepard. Let's do this later.
We'll talk later.
Commander.
Lieutenant. At least I think he's a lieutenant. Research. Upgrades. We haven't scanned any planets for a long time, so we're like using this crap up. Damage protection. Plenty. It's palladium. Tech damage, 30%. Oh, it's got hard shields here. These are, yeah. Hard shields, palladium. 5,000. Shepherd shields take 20% less damage. Cool. And tech cooldowns. Wow, we're just about out of element zero. 20% faster cooldown on tech abilities. We need more elements.
Still need to get to Tuchanka, Shepard. My students are being held by Bloodpack.
I'll talk to you later, Morden.
We'll be here if you need me.
We'll be wandering around the ship if you need me. We'll talk to Kelly and Joker.
You had me so worried when you were trapped on the Collector ship. Thank goodness for Edie.
This is flirting. Worried? You do care.
That sounds like more than just professional concern, Kelly.
You're more than just my commander. You're my friend. Edie brought you back to me. If she had a body, I'd give her a big hug.
Yeah. What about me? I hope this isn't leading me into cheating on Liara or something.
I'm standing right here. Where's my hug?
Aw. That's a friend hug.
Welcome back, man. Anyway, how may I help you, Commander?
How's the crew?
Is there anything I should know?
You have unread messages at your private terminal. Samara would like to see you in observation on the crew deck. Anything else, Commander?
Chat?
Do you have a moment to talk?
I always have time for you, Commander.
Okay.
I better go.
Okay. Maybe we'll talk later. Commander, you've received a new message at your private terminal.
You've already said that. Thank you. We got a hug. Still alive. From Detective Anaya. On Ilium? Greetings, Commander. I'm not completely sure this will get to you, but thanks again for helping me deal with Samara. Oh, yes. The Eclipse mercs have gotten real quiet around here, and my superiors have backed off, too. No idea if the two are related, but hopefully the next time I meet a Justicar, I can give her the respect she deserves. I still can't believe I worked a case with one of them. You're a lucky human. If I find any more data on her target, I'll pass it along. Thanks. Detective Anaya, Ilium Law Enforcement. Cool. Let's check on Zajoka.
So the Collectors were once Protheans, repurposed by the Reapers. What a sad end.
Makes you wonder if the Keepers on the Citadel were once something different.
Undoubtedly, they were genetically modified from something, right? Couldn't it be just made from scratch? Or could they?
Commander.
How are things in the cockpit?
I assume everything's going well up here?
Good for now. Fractured my thumb on the mute, but I think I made my point.
Alright, nothing to say about all that crap. Okay.
That's it for now.
See ya, Commander.
See ya. Okay, so now we head... Let me just feed the fish real quick. I'll head for engineering. Our two engineers might actually have something new to say. I'm surprised Joker didn't.
So, Kenneth, did you know we've got a crazy woman squatting down in the subdeck?
Jack.
What? If she touches anything, I'll kill her.
Oh, and the only thing she wears from her waist up is tattoos.
Oh, maybe I should go down and welcome her aboard.
And she's a murderer. Has biotic powers that could crush you with a blink. Hates everyone in Cerberus.
Damn it, girl. Stop toying with me.
These two should just get married again and get married already and get it over with.
What can we do for you, Commander?
Carry on.
Will do, Commander.
Alright, so... let's go visit the aforementioned crazy lady. See if she has anything new to say.
I need to get to Pragya, Shepard. Soon.
I'll think about that. Meanwhile, I have to go.
Yep.
She's wearing something above the waist. It's a little, like, leather band. I wonder if she doesn't get cold down here with all this metal. Said?
This mission takes me back.
What mission?
Collectors and Protheans.
Oh.
It's all about my pay grade. I'm more used to putting down rebellions, tracking down bastards who didn't pay their gambling debts. Still, even I know a galaxy-shaking revelation when I hear one. Makes fighting land wars for pay seem small time. New smoke, Shepard? Don't. That stuff will kill you.
Nope.
New kid once. Weapons dealer. Probably half your age. Bastard smoked too close to a cache of explosives. Tossed a butt, blew himself sky high.
Smart.
I should let you go. Talk more later, Shepard.
Suppose you have anything new to say.
Have time now, Shepard. I need to deal with this.
I don't have a lot of time right now. Can we do this later?
That is your decision. But don't wait too long, Shepard.
Yeah, dangerous. Yeah, that's it for this level then. Crew quarters. Thane?
Shepard, is there time to visit the Citadel yet?
Not yet.
I shall return to my meditations.
I shall return to checking on people. Sammy?
Hey, got a minute?
You sound so cheerful.
Gabby and Ken would make a great couple. I just doubt they'll ever realize it.
I was just saying that.
The Normandy runs so quietly. I'm not used to hearing my footsteps when I walk. One of the girls in navigation thinks she might be pregnant. Even aboard a Cerberus vessel, life finds a way.
That's true.
Come back later. I'm sure I'll have more to talk about.
Anything? Nothing. Collectors, man. Nothing new to say. Okay, I think she's in here. Yeah, Samara.
I am glad you came.
Good.
I must ask for your help. That is not easy for me.
You use biotic powers just to stand up? Take your time.
It's all right. Just tell me what you need.
When we met on Ilium, I told you about a very dangerous person I was pursuing. Using
yes.
the information you obtained, I have located her.
The ship
She's
name?
Been going by the name Morinth.
Morinth.
I would like to apprehend her before she disappears again.
What's the importance of this mission?
How important is this?
Killing her has been my focus for 400 years.
Damn.
It is the most important thing in my life, and the reason I became a Justicar.
Really? What's the urgency of the mission?
Didn't you say you'd pick up her trail after our mission?
I know where she is, right now. In a month, she may be gone. This is the best opportunity I've ever had.
Where is she?
Where is she?
Omega. A nightclub
Go back to Omega.
Afterlife, which seems a perfect place for her to hunt.
So I've been there. Who is she?
Tell me about her.
She is an Ardat Yakshi.
A what?
It is a term from a dead Asari dialect. It means demon of the night winds.
Cool.
That is mythology. She is simply a very dangerous woman who kills without mercy.
Huh. Sounds like you.
You're dangerous too.
As are you. But she is different. Morinth suffers a rare genetic disorder. When she mates with you, there is no gentle melding of nervous systems.
Oh my.
She overpowers yours. Burns it out, hemorrhages your brain. You end up a mindless shell, and soon after, you are dead.
Holy crap! Sounds like the sci-fi version of a succubus. Killing because of genes?
So you hunt down these Asari just because they're born with a genetic condition?
It manifests with maturity. When one is diagnosed, she is offered the chance to live in seclusion and comfort. If she refuses, it shows her addiction to the ecstasy she gets from killing her mates. There is no redemption for such a person.
What's too extreme? The ecstasy or killing her? Does she have a compulsion to do this?
Can't she abstain?
Each encounter gives her strength. The effect is narcotic. The more she does it, the more she needs to do it. She will never stop. She can't.
She's gotta fix her boobs or something. One of them looks off. obscurity?
Why isn't this ever mentioned in Asari literature or art?
When we were primitive, there was much fascination with Ardat Yakshi. Some cultures worship them as gods of destruction. Now the Asari have a place in the galaxy, and they don't wish this defect to be widely known. As far as I know, only three exist today. Two chose a life of seclusion. The third ran.
Morinth.
She ran, and I am sworn to kill her.
See why she's dangerous.
This is definitely worthy of your full attention.
She confuses her victims, twists their feelings. They will do anything for her favor.
I'll think about it. We will go, but later.
If we have time, we'll deal with it.
There is one thing more. This creature, this monster. She is my daughter.
Oh my. Other children?
You said this is genetic. How many children do you have?
Three. And three Ardat Yakshi are in existence today. It is as it sounds. Marinth was always the wild one. She was happy and free, but selfish.
All three are your kids? Wait, say it again?
You said this is genetic. How many children do you have?
Three. And three Ardat Yakshi are in existence today. Marinth was always the wild one. She was happy and free, but selfish.
So then what about yourself? So sorry.
I cannot imagine what this is like for you.
I do not want pity, Shepard. I do not accept it.
No huggy
my
from this one.
My condition is my fault, and my redemption lies in killing her.
Sheesh.
Do not pity me. Simply understand my situation.
No? No what? Don't understand? Or don't do it? Tell me more.
How did all this happen?
I spent my youth on the move, adventuring. I killed people, mated with them, or just danced the night away. I learned so much, experienced so much. And then my matron days came. I could finally sit back, bask, and enjoy my family. But in one moment, it was all taken away.
Oh, cry me a river. It must have been hard.
Sounds terrible.
I sat in a med lab while a nearsighted doctor droned at me, and I learned that nothing was as I thought it would be. I gave up all that I possessed. I own nothing, claim nothing. All my knowledge will die with me. Now my purpose is to destroy my own children.
I understand.
Those moments change you.
And I've hundreds of years left to live with that. I say too much. Forgive me. Help me find my long-lost daughter. And kill her.
Like I said, we're gonna get to it.
If there's time, maybe we can go to Omega.
I hope we can go to Omega soon.
I'll think about that. Meanwhile, I have to go.
Of course.
We got Paragon. This time I will check in on the good doctor.
How may I help you, Commander?
I'll see you later, Doctor.
Commander?
I can't believe the Collectors were once Protheans.
I always pictured Protheans being regal, not giant bugs.
Yeah, really.
Who knows what the Reapers did to them? Creepy.
How can I help you, Commander?
I won't take any more of your time.
Back to work.
Checking on Garrus really quick. And then Miranda.
Any chance we could get to the Citadel, Shepard? I'd like to follow that lead on Sidomis.
I'll let you know, Garrus.
I'll be here if you need me.
I don't think Miranda's gonna have any new say. But just to be thorough.
If we have time, I'd like to go to Ilium and relocate my sister's family.
I'll let you know, Miranda.
Of course, Commander.
Yeah, blame your elusive man friend. Pull us away. I don't even know where the hell we are right now. Where are we? Look. Calliston Rift. Damn. Okay, well, stay tuned for next episode. Guess we're going to explore these systems in the Calliston Rift, and then after that we're going to head back to Ilium, take care of Miranda's thing, and then we have to check in on some guy down there, and we'll explore the rest of that system. That's the Crescent Nebula. We've only explored the Tassala system in that nebula. So thanks for watching. See you next time, and enduring. Grow strong.